Hi, Paul Gerrard back again to talk to you this time about substantiation of work deductions by an individual. Now, this is an area that a lot of taxpayers really get wrong. Here's the story that everyone thinks is correct. You can claim up to $300 worth of deductions and you don't need to have receipts. Okay, sort of true, but really wrong. Now, here's how it really works. A taxpayer with no more than $300 of deductions doesn't need to substantiate all those expenses. Okay, so let's say you've paid your tax agent fee last year and it was $250, and then you claimed $100 for work-related laundry related to your compulsory bank uniform. You've exceeded the $300 limit. You must have receipts and substantiate all of your deductions, not just some of it or the amount over $300. Now, this fallacy really comes into its own when we start looking at, say, a property investor who owns an investment property. And I get told this by a lot of people. They say, but I can claim $300 for this deduction. I claim $300 for this deduction. I claim $300 for this deduction. I don't have any receipts. That's not true, okay? So if you're a property investor, because you're probably paying interest, you've exceeded your $300, receipts or substantiation evidence for everything, okay? So you can't, let's say you don't have a receipt for a repair, you really shouldn't be claiming a deduction, okay? So it's important that you carefully and meticulously retain receipts. Now, I've got a way I'd like to share with you. There's a couple of different ways, but on my device, I've got Dropbox. Take a photo of the receipt, upload to Dropbox. Filed away under the relevant folder. You can never lose a receipt if you take a photograph of it then and there. Now, it's not always going to work for everybody. You might use something else, but that's just one way I'd like to share with you to ensure that you don't miss these deductions, that you get to the end of the year and you go, oh, that's right, I remember paying that. So you haven't missed the deduction, okay? So substantiation. Now, other ways to substantiate don't need receipts. Now, what do I mean by that? It might be a diary related to work-related travel. So cents per kilometre, keep a diary record. Here's a list or a reasonable calculation basis if you travel on a frequent basis to a particular place, not to and from work. But let's say you're going to a different office or a different client premise. Keep a record, or at the end of the year, calculate out your total kilometres, and we can claim up to 5,000 kilometres, and you don't need to have a logbook or anything like that, and it can be beneficial. Now, common one that the people claim, substantiation for internet, phone, and data. Now, this is a complex one. The tax office has gone to great lengths in the last year or so to clarify this deduction. Here's what you need to do. You need to pick out a representative 1 month bill during that year. And then you need to carefully consider the cost that was incurred in that month. And it gets complicated because some of these days you've all got these data plans where uncapped data and you included phone calls. So the fact that you made 45 text messages to your boss may not actually add much to the cost if they're fully included in your bill. And there's a basis for calculating that. And you might need to carefully consider, well, how many text messages did I send over the course of that month? And what else did I do during that month? And how does it relate to my total cost? For example, if your SMS and if your call costs, let's say, $25 out of the total bill, then it might only be a proportion of the $25 per month that relates to the SMS messages cost. You know what I mean? But you've got to have that analysis of 1 month's bill, otherwise no deduction at all. And if you've got things like Foxtel on it, obviously a common one we hear is, oh, but I'm in the finance industry, I need the Foxtel because, well, I'm going to tell you this, it's unlikely it's deductible. It's like buying the Sydney Morning Herald to find out what happened yesterday in the stock market. If you're in the stock market and you don't read about what happened yesterday as part of your job, that's hindsight reporting. It's not part of your job. So be careful with those sorts of approaches to costs, such as Foxtel and things like that. I'm not saying they're not deductible. I've encountered people who are in the industry, who are in the entertainment TV industry, and it is very important to their role. And yes, they have claimed deductions. So it's really an area for guidance and advice. Anyhow, so that covers our general rules on substantiation. I hope we've cleared up the issue of the $300 rule, and we don't want to see anyone get pinged by the ATO, particularly if, when they're on the phone to you and they say, why did you claim that? And you say, but you're allowed to claim $300, and they say, no, and then they just deny your deduction, okay? So give us a call, give us an email, happy to help, and we look forward to speaking with you, or we'll see you again, another video on our YouTube channel or our website. Cheers. Bye.